about set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. See how this game plays out as they get ready for the opening kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. Tulsa staff and their fans have heard all week long their quarterback's going to play terribly on the road. I think their staff's got them ready to prove them wrong right now.
I think this staff really has rallied this entire team around some of that negative talk. And I think they believe in their guy, that he can go on the road and make the plays and lead them to a big victory. You know, sometimes when you hit some adversity like that, you see teams circle the wagons. And I really believe this week they've done a great job of doing that. Now they just have to go out and execute the plan and go out and win this game.
Throw, and down he goes at the 50-yard line.
Great job by the quarterback. He had a slant called against zone coverage and threw it at the perfect time.
He scrambled. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. Dives forward. He gets to about the 27-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Makes it to the 17. The 17-yard line. Second down. The 5. Touchdown, Golden Hurricane. Great call by the offensive coordinator.
Big time play, taking that ball all the way in. Maybe the defense wasn't expecting a run.
There's a player down. I'm not sure what happened. And he adds the extra point. A 7-play, 75-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 26. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game.
With the safeties coming up, making plays near the line of scrimmage, that tells your offense they've got to start throwing the ball to keep them honest.
Second down and 9 to go. Ball on the 27-yard line. He's into the open field. Nice run there as they work the outside. Pitches back. He's tackled
at about the 43-yard line.
Awesome running here on third down. That can bring a lot of confidence to an offense when they can pull that off so successfully.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43-yard line. And they'll run him again. They'll bring him down around the 43-yard line.
That makes it second and 10.
Throws a bullet. Oh, he had a shot at the pick.
You like a team that's ready to defend the pass. It takes some preparation to get in the way of a pass like that.
And so it's another third down upcoming here. Throws down the middle. Finds the junior. And they make the stop at the 12-yard line.
It definitely put them in better field position. And I just have a feeling that they're going to punch it into the end zone on this drive.
So after the big pass play, we've got a first down. Finds his man and they take him down immediately. Here's the eighth play of the series. Touchdown, Horned Frogs. Strong run by the halfback to get into the end zone.
He's a pretty sure bet to get six when you're this close to the end zone.
We'll be tied with the extra point. And he tacks on the extra point. An eight-play, 73-yard drive. And they put up 7 points. We get a tie game at 7-7. TCU to kick. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing. And he's tackled at the 25. Down at the 41. Tackle made at the 50. He's at the 40. And he's taken down at the 29-yard line. He makes it to the 28-yard line. Goes out to the tight end again, completes. He's taken down at the 24-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That'll make it third and five.
Third and five situation. Ball on the 24. There's a strike complete. And that sets them up for the first and goal.
He made a really good move at the line of scrimmage. Sometimes all you need to do is throw off the defender's timing just a little bit at the start of the play.
Five wide. Throws it and it's caught for the touchdown. Splits the uprights with the extra point. kick this one away. Sends it sailing downfield. Gets out to about the 21.
Boy, the two offensive coordinators have to be loving this. In fact, you can look over our booth next to us and see how much they're enjoying it with a big smile on their face. The defensive coordinators, on the other hand, might be looking for a pink slip on Monday. Brad, let's see if this offense can maintain the rhythm that they established on that last drive. Not just putting points on the board, but driving the length of the field to be able to eventually put points up. I think that's going to be important for them to try to keep that confidence going here on this drive.
It's second down, six to go. Ball on their own 25. Good tackle there in space. There are three quarters remaining. Tulsa's lead is a touchdown. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. At about the 41. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. Fires quickly, and it's picked off. And down he goes at the 41-yard line. And just a great interception by the cornerback.
Well, that's big time. He made a great read on the quarterback and got in there for the pick.
From their own 41-yard line, first down. Tulsa up 7 points. He's into the open field. Gains his way to midfield.
That makes it second and two.
Caught and out of bounds after a short gain. The pass is complete for 4 yards, and that'll be a first down.
Nothing special here. Quick pass and a good catch, but it keeps the chains moving.
And I think it was the quick throw by the quarterback that fouled up the defense on that one. And he just gets rid of it. From the 46-yard line, second down. Slings it out, and it gets tipped. Throws it out right to the running back. And he is drilled at the 43-yard line. A pickup of about three.
The offense is trying to get the ball into the hands of the halfback here, and he did a pretty good job of getting a few yards, but the defense was just swarming to the ball right there.
Let's see if he aims for the sideline and tries to get this thing down deep in their own territory. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. The quarterback threw an interception on their last drive. Let's see if they can be more successful here.
The last possession didn't go in the favor for this offense. I'd expect to see them come out and be a little bit more conservative with some safe play calling in order to avoid another bad result.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. They bring him down in the backfield.
He was never able to get ahead of steam on that carry.
That'll bring up third and four.
Now he's scrambling. Now he's going to run and watch out. He's tackled
at about the 43-yard line.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 43. Here's an opening. 6 yards there on the option keeper.
That's a gain of 6 on the play. That'll make it 2nd and 4.
And a quick throw. He's knocked down a bounds. Around the 49-yard line. It's 3rd down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. A gain of 1.
This was just a little dump-off pass to the halfback, but it was very well defended, keeping them from moving the ball very far downfield.
And he carries the ball for a nice gain. From the 44-yard line, it's 1st down. He's on the run. They'll bring him down at the 33. It's the 9th play of the drive. Pushed out of bounds. From the 20-yard line, 1st down. The halfback with a carry. And he hits him hard at the 11-yard line. The offensive line got a really good push there, allowing the back to pick up 9 on the play. This is the 11th play of this drive. Some daylight. Nice run there.
The offense coordinator right now is very happy with the execution. That's the 5th first down on this drive alone. The big thing is when you have this kind of drive going, you don't want to end it in a field goal. Now you want to focus on trying to put the football into the end zone.
If you don't get the blocking on the outside, the toss play is going to fail 99% of the time.
From the 9-yard line, it's 2nd down. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield.
I like how the defense got all up into that option to disrupt it. The offense looks a bit unsettled after losing that battle.
To the end zone, touchdown. They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. And he converts the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. Slings it out there incomplete.
Great hands there by the wide receiver. Unfortunately for him, he couldn't get a foot down inbounds.
It's 2nd and 10. Ball on the 25. Steps out at the 27-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That'll bring up 3rd and 8.
Man left, man left. Go down,
He gets out to about the 37-yard line.
The play was very well conceived as they were able to get a decent gain and a first down.
First and 10. Ball on the 37-yard line. And they make the stop at the 49-yard line.
I tell you what, this defense better start to get pressure on the quarterback. They're giving him way too much time back there to throw the football.
Pushed out of bounds around the 41-yard line.
What impresses me so much is the guy's vision. He read the coverage perfectly to find his man for good yardage.
So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. He's scrambling. And they got him. That's a great tackle. The 37-yard line. With a quick throw. That close to being intercepted. So we've played two quarters. We're deadlocked right now at 14.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bruce Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always, to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes.
We say it here all the time. It's not always about the X's and the O's. It can be about the Jimmys and the Joes. But I think Jimmy and Joe appear to be pretty evenly matched here. And this might not necessarily be about who has the better athlete, who has the more explosive player. This might come down to which guy maneuvering those X's and O's does so the most wisely.
Well, who's telling Jimmy and Joe where to line up? They gotta know where they're supposed to go. So I think it is important. And the coaches, sometimes you got to break character. You know, sometimes you know you're a predominantly run team, and that's what you do, and you're going to line up and pound it. But sometimes you face a good defense that's playing really well that they're not going to allow you to do that. And sometimes you got to get a little bit out of character. And I think which offense or which defense can take a few chances and get rewarded for those chances, come up on the plus side of it, create a big turnover, set your offense up on the right side of here. Why don't you dial up one of those trick plays you got in your bag that you haven't used in a while that you think might could work and might could maybe bust open this game and give you a little bit of separation.
That's going to do it for David and me here in the studio. Time to get you back to the game. Brad and Kirk ready to take you home in the second half.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. He sends this one deep. And he's tackled at the 20. I think it says something about the quality of the preparation of both teams that we're into the third quarter and nobody's been able to pull away. Both sides seem to know what to expect. He's out to the 30. He gets to about the 31-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 31-yard line. Makes it to the 41. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go.
Three down.
Oh. Fires that quickly, incomplete. So that'll make it fourth down.
The defense held their ground on that play. The quarterback just wasn't able to find any open receivers.
Fielded at the 19. They'll bring him down at the 33-yard line. A lot of times you'll see teams start to clench up a little bit when games stay close well into the second half. You need to stay loose, keep doing what you've been doing all week in practice, and execute when it's time. Throws incomplete. From their own 33-yard line. Second down. Tackled right around the 32-yard line. Hit as he threw, and he completes it. Gets him open field. Brought down right around the 44-yard line. Delivers to the halfback on the screen. He gets hit out of bounds at the 30. He's taken down at the 28-yard line.
That makes it 7-8.
He's taken down at the 26-yard line. They've been two for two on third downs in this drive, and they'll try to convert again here. Zips it to the back. And they got to him before he could get back to the line. Field goal unit here for this long field goal attempt. Tulsa could take the lead with this field goal. It has the distance, and it's up the upright, and it's good. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He'll return it from the three. He's taken down at the 30-yard line. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. He makes his way to about the 38. Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. He makes it to the 38-yard line.
Well, this is the kind of play you want to see if you're a defensive player, because not only is it a negative play, but this can really impact and affect the emotion of the game. Just looking down and looking at the energy on the field and even on the sidelines, you can see that the defense is fired up after that play.
At the 49. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 49. Quick pass, intercepted. And there isn't anyone who's going to catch this cornerback. He's at the 30, and down he goes at about the 21.
I just don't think he saw the defender, and he threw the ball right at him. That's what happens when you focus on one guy. You get tunnel vision.
From the 21-yard line, first down. Tulsa is up a field goal. Now he tries to buy some time. What a play, and that is first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
Fires complete over the middle. He's tackled at the 5.
That's a gain of 4 on that play. That brings him second and goal.
He scrambled. He's got the corner. And he's going to run this one in. Touchdown.
A powerful push by the line and a really nice run. That'll get you into the end zone almost every time.
And he adds the extra point. Like they're ready for the kick. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. Makes it to the 22-yard line.
Tulsa's coaches just got to be happy. I'd love to coach a kid like this.
Oh, I think these coaches love to coach a guy like this. And another great performance by him individually and for this offense.
An interception cut this offense last drive short. So I think they're going to be looking for a little more success right here.
This quarterback can make good passes. He just needs to focus on not forcing the ball to his receivers.
From their own 20-yard line, second down. And they get him in the backfield for a loss. There's a player down. I'm not sure what happened.
That brings us 3rd and 14.
That's three down and one to go. Tulsa's got a 10-point lead. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number 4. We're still early in the fourth quarter, but that was a huge stop. And now with the lead, they're going to get the football back and an opportunity to stretch the lead. Looks like they've decided to go for it here. Taken down in the backfield. And that was a big stop defensively.
Yeah, they only needed a few yards here to keep the drive alive. Great job by the defense to shut them down.
Really a great stop by the defense. This will go down as one of those critical plays. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Laterals back. And they get nice yardage on that run. And the option to the halfback gets 6 yards.
That'll bring up 2nd and 3.
Quick out to his receiver. They'll bring him down at about the 17-yard line. He might have a chance. He gets out to about the 8.
That makes it 2nd and 2.
Watch 36 to Mike.
He gets out to about the 6-yard line.
That makes it first and goal.
And they hit him in the backfield. Ball inside the 10-yard line. It's second down. Hand off inside. Touchdown, Golden Hurricanes.
Outstanding run and great execution by the entire offensive unit, especially the blocking up front.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. Across the 30. Got the corner. And he shoved out of bounds at the 39. And the defense made a big stop on fourth down the last time this offense was out there.
You know, the last time this offense was out on the field, they went for it on fourth down, Brad, and they came up short. I think as an offensive coordinator and a play caller, you've got to be very selective on when to go for it and when maybe to just punt the ball to change the field position.
It's second and 9. Ball on their own 40. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. And they make the stop around the 49-yard line. Just under 3 to go in regulation. Finds the junior, and he's tackled around the 37-yard line. He's going to try and scramble. They bring him down.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
Second down and 11. Ball on the 37. Fires quickly to the tight end. Brought down at the 32-yard line.
Call it a gain of 5 yards. That'll bring up 3rd and 6.
Deep pass to the end zone. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it.
Number 85 was the intended receiver on the play.
It's 4th down and they're going to try to go for it. He's scrambling. Room around the corner. No one open, so he's going to run. Slides down to the ground.
Well, this is a nice run for the first down by this quarterback.
Big play there, and now they're looking at 1st and goal. 1st down. 1st and goal here inside the 5-yard line. Gobbled up in the backfield.
The option can be really tough to defend. At that time, it was well played by the defense.
This is the 10th play of this drive. A little over a minute in the game. And they'll get him in the backfield.
That was just a case of one lineman dominating another and making the play.
So here we go. It's 3rd and goal from the 3-yard line. The short yardage defense here. Touchdown, TCU! kicks the PAT. He's tackled at the 37-yard line. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Makes it to the 27. He caught some key blocks and was able to turn it into a 10-yard gain. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. And he hits him hard at the 25-yard line. And that run will move the chain.
Oh, boy, that was a tough one to give up for that defense.
He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. A yard, maybe two on the carry. TCU's called their final timeout. And he carries the ball for a nice game. It's third down and five to go. Ball on the 19. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. That's a game seven. First down. Two times. In a game that had to be a defensive coordinator's worst nightmare, it's over. 31-21, Tulsa. So that wraps things up for us. 3A Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.